Hi! Today we'll learn how to consume current and historical currency data using Python and Pandas. Before we begin, we will need an elementary understanding of Python, Visual Studio Code with Jupyter Notebook plugin installed, and an API key. You can sign up for our API for free. Once you have the API key, please note it in a safe place. You can also use Google Colab to follow the tutorial. Let's start! In our first block, we will import requests and import and define pretty printer to process our API request. In our new block, we define the following. URL is the endpoint we will be calling. Currency is a comma-separated string. API key will hold the key string you receive after signing up. Query string holds the JSON parameters that we will pass to the request. The response is what we get back from the API. Finally, we print the response we receive using Pretty Printer. We have received live rates for USD/JPY and GBP/USD. Now we introduce Pandas to do some data analysis. Pandas can also get the data from the API. As you can see, the Pandas data frame above is more readable. To make it easier to understand, we will import NumPy, a library that complements Pandas, then change the instrument column. Then we create a new column called timestamp and convert it to a readable timestamp. We also define the columns for table. You can save your work with a single command and share your work via a CSV file. The daily historical data endpoint is very similar to the live endpoint. We will adjust the endpoint for daily historical. We add date we require data for. Add date to query as well. Replace timestamp with date. And instead of bid mid, ask we look for OHLC, and we get our adjusted data based on this. For minute and hour based historical data, we'll do one example as they are both identical. We set the currency pairs we need, the dates we need, and an empty array to hold our adjusted response. We set our endpoint, and then we loop through our currency pairs and run a nested loop for the dates we need, defining our query string, response, and adding the response to the empty array. We now run our Pandas data frame and get the adjusted tabulated data. There it is. Thank you for watching. Remember to like, subscribe, and turn on notifications.